Let us derive the equation for specific heat of solid. So firstly, let me consider a simple calorimeter. So I am considering like a simple diagram. Consider that it's an calorimeter. Imagine that it's an calorimeter along with the stirrer. Along with the stirrer, this is the stirrer. So this is the calorimeter. Imagine that this is the calorimeter and this is the stirrer. The mass of the combination of the calorimeter along with the stirrer as m1. Let us consider the mass of this one as m1. Means that calorimeter cal plus stirrer, STIR. So calorimeter plus stirrer, mass equals to m1. Let us consider that. Next, now what we tries to do is simply pour some water into this calorimeter. Pour some water into this calorimeter. Pour some water means till 1/3 of this calorimeter. So pour 1/3 volume of water into this calorimeter. So this is 1/3 volume of this calorimeter, and consider the total mass of this is m2. Consider that this total mass of this calorimeter along with the water is m2. That means calorimeter plus stirrer plus mass of the water. Water equals to m2. Here either we consider water. Water equals to m2. Let us suppose if we wants to find out the mass of the water particularly, then what we tries to do is, we already know that the mass of calorimeter plus stirrer equals to m1. So this value is equals to m1. If we wants to find out the mass of the water, send this m1 into that side. So simply now we get mass of water that is equals to m2 minus m1. This is the mass of the water. This is the mass of the water. So next thing is that, now consider the water and the calorimeter have the same temperature, and the temperature of this calorimeter as T1. So this is the temperature of the calorimeter along with the water. So the temperature of this calorimeter along with the water is T1. Consider the temperature as T1. And next thing is that, I'm going to consider another vessel. I mean, like this is the steam heater. Imagine that it's an steam heater. Imagine that it is an steam heater. Imagine that it's an steam heater. And I have placed some lead salts into this steam heater and heated up to 100 degrees Celsius. Now measure the temperature of this lead salts as T2. I have considered a steam heater. Let's imagine that it's a steam heater and I have placed the lead salts into the steam heater and I have raised the temperature till 100 degrees Celsius. At that instant, consider the temperature as T2. I mean, this 100 degrees Celsius, I'm going to consider temperature as T2. Now, what I'm going to do is, take this lead salts and place it into the calorimeter, which is having a water, 1/3 volume of water. Let us consider, this is the calorimeter. Now what I am trying to do is, this is the stirrer and it is already contains 1/3 volume of the water. Now what I am going to do is, so I am going to replace these lead salts into this calorimeter without loss of the heat. So by the minimum loss of the heat. So now I have replaced these lead salts into this calorimeter. Now what would be the mass of this calorimeter when the lead salts are mixed into this calorimeter? So now it is going to be considered as M3. Particularly, we have to find out the mass of the lead salts. So how do we calculate the mass of the lead salts? Let's find out. So we already know that it is the mixture of calorimeter plus stirrer plus water plus lead salts equals to M3. This is actually what we know. We already know that calorimeter plus stirrer plus water mass equals to M2. We already know that calorimeter plus stirrer plus water mass equals to M2. Means that till this point, we can replace that M2. Now we can find out the mass of the lead salts as mass of the lead salts equals to, now the mass of the lead salts equals to M3 minus M2. M3 minus M2. Is it visible? Yeah. M3 minus M2. So this is the mass of the, that is the mass of the lead salts. Now what we need to find out is, whenever we are trying to replace these lead salts into this calorimeter, the lead salts which are having the higher temperature, those are going to be lost the temperature, and the water and the calorimeter are going to gain the temperature. So by that concept, we can find out the specific heat of the lead salt. So now let's find out. From this, it is very clear that the lead salts are going to lose the temperature, and the calorimeter along with water, that is going to be gain the temperature. According to the heat principle, the heat lost by the one body is always equals to the heat gained by the another body. That means the heat lost by the hotter body is always equals to the heat gained by the colder body. So now here what we need to do is, so let's write the given data. Firstly, what is the, if we consider which is going to be lost the temperature, so this is data related to lead salts, and which is going to gain the temperature, that is water and calorimeter are going to gain the temperature. Now write the data related to lead salts and this water and calorimeter. Firstly, what is the mass of the lead salts? The mass of the lead salts is M3 minus M2. And the specific heat of the lead salt is S suffix L. The specific heat of the lead salts is S suffix L. What is the temperature of the specific, the temperature of the lead salts that we considered? T2. This is the data that related to lead salts. Similarly, write the data related to water and the calorimeter. What is the mass of the water? M2 minus M1. This is the mass of the water. And what is the specific heat of the water? S suffix W is the specific heat of the water. So here if you want, you can write that this is mass of the water. So this is the specific heat of the water, and the temperature of the water is T1. Similarly, for calorimeter also, calorimeter mass of the calorimeter is equals to M1, and the specific heat of the calorimeter equals to S of XC, and the temperature of the calorimeter equals to T1. As we said, the temperature of the water and the calorimeter are having the same temperature. So now this is the data that related to water and the calorimeter. So when we mix these two substances together, here we are going to get the resultant temperature. This is the resultant temperature. Consider that this is the resultant temperature, that is T3. When we mix these two lead salts and the calorimeter along with the water, we are going to get the resultant temperature, that is, I am going to consider that T3. So now, according to the heat principle, the heat lost by the lead salts must be equals to the heat gained by the water and along with the calorimeter. So that we know that the equation for heat, Q is equals to M into S into delta T. By substituting these variables into this equation, we'll get the answer, that is, the heat lost by the lead salts equals to the heat gained by the calorimeter along with the water. So the heat lost by the lead salts equals to M3 minus M2. This is the mass into specific heat is S(L) into change in temperature. This is going to lose the temperature. So how much temperature that is going to be lost? T3 temperature. So that's why T2 minus T3. That is equals to the heat gained by the objects or water as well as calorimeter. So firstly write down for water. For water it is M2 minus M1 and the specific heat is S(W). The heat gained is, so it is already gained the temperature. So from this body onwards, from T3 onwards, it is going to be transferred to T1. So that means T3 minus T1 plus the similarly, a calorimeter also going to gain the temperature, that is M1 into specific heat S(C) into change in temperature is what? T3 minus T1. This is the value that we are going to get. So from this, can we find out the specific heat of the solid? Simply. So we need to find out the specific heat of the solid. So S(L). So that's why I send this all data into that side simply. So that means S(L) is equals to, so from this, is there any common term? T3 minus T1 is the common term. So then M2 minus M1 into SW plus M1 into S(C) whole into T3 minus T1. This is the common term, whole by remaining term is, send these two values into that side, that is M3 minus M2 into T2 minus T3. So this is the resultant temperature that we are going to get. So here it is visible. So the final temperature is, the specific heat of the solids is M2 minus M1 into S(W) plus M1 into S(W) whole into T3 minus T1 whole by M3 minus M2 into T2 minus T3. This is the equation for specific heat of solids. Okay.